One thing that really stands out to me here is the difference in roles. So it seems like we have someone in the middle that is the center of this transaction that actually the information relates to.
Traditionally, we've always had the concept of issuers, so people who are obviously creating the information and sending it out, and verifiers, or sometimes known as relying parties, who are taking that information and sort of using it in their current context. But really now in the decentralized model, we're introducing this third role, which is what we call the holder. And it's really the person, the subject of the information that the credential is holding. And it puts them in a real active position as part of that transaction model.
Right. So could we look at an example?
Yeah. So here we've got a company called Field Services, and they've got an employee called Emma. Now, she'll need to be able to access some of those internal services used by her employer. So she needs to be able to sort of log in and access those. But she also goes off to a number of different client sites and needs to actually access services at those partner sites as well. So what we find in the current model is that Emma would log into their Field Services, and she would have she'd be a record in a database along with a whole load of other employees. And then she can access those internal services just fine using that. But when she goes off to a client site, what you then find is that all those different clients would need to have a connection back to the Field Services data source so that they can actually check to see if, you know, Emma's a trusted employee effectively. In a decentralized world, what the issuer can do, so Field Services, they can issue a credential, an employee credential probably, down to Emma. She can keep it about her. And when she goes off to one of those clients, she can just present that credential directly to them. Because it's a portable credential, they can take the trust from that credential and allow Emma to access the services on their site.
Wow. So does that mean that centralized databases actually disappear, or there wouldn't need to be a connection back to these centralized databases?
No, not at all. I mean, it's still really important that an employer knows about all the employees that they have on records. You know, that doesn't change. What does change, though, is probably just the boundary of how that information is shared and distributed. Mm-hmm. So if we take that example of Field Services issuing out credentials to their employees, and then those employees going out to different client sites, that's what we call a bit of an ecosystem that's starting to build up there. And anyone who issues a really high-value trusted credential as part of that ecosystem, we would probably call that the trust anchor.
Okay.
And effectively what they're now doing is issuing credentials out that other participants in the ecosystem will trust. And they can even be considered as almost foundational. So you can actually start layering other credentials on top of those.